Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you the use of FEOF function available in file handling in C. Before starting, you can note how you can search my YouTube channel. You can type my name Sanjay Gupta in YouTube. My channel will be available there. You can watch various programming related videos here. Now I am going to implement solution of this problem. So first I have included a header file stdio.h. Another header file stdlib.h. Now I am going to define main function. Inside main function I am declaring a file pointer, that is fp. Then I have declared a character variable, that is ch. Now I am opening a file whose name is contain.txt, and I am opening it in read mode. And the address of this file will be stored inside fp. Now I have to check whether this file is opened successfully or not. So this if statement will be checking fp is equals to null or not. So if it is equals to null, then I can print an error message, that is cannot open file, and I can call exit function so that execution of the program can be terminated. Now after this if condition, I have to implement the use of FEOF. So for that purpose, I am going to implement while loop. Now inside this while condition, I am calling FEOF and I am passing FP inside this FEOF function. So FEOF function checks the location of file pointer. It FEOF returns non-zero if file pointer is on end of file, otherwise zero. So you have to focus on this comment. FEOF is a predefined function which checks location of file pointer, and it returns non-zero if file pointer is on end of file, otherwise it returns zero. So now suppose file pointer is in middle of file, it means there are some contents available in a file, so FEOF will return 0, and 0 means false, so this loop will not repeat. And I want to repeat this loop if file pointer is on some content of the file. So I am applying not here, so not will convert false into true so that this loop will repeat. And if FEOF checks a file pointer location, and if file pointer is on EOF, then it will return non-zero. So non-zero is considered as true. But if file pointer is on end of file, then I have to terminate this loop. So non-zero will be converted into zero if I am writing this not operator. So whenever you checks file pointer location with the help of this FEOF function, then you have to use this not operator so that loop can be repeated properly. Now inside this loop, I can read values available in file with the help of fgetc. So the received character will be stored inside ch, and I can print that character on output screen with the help of printf. So this way I have implemented this loop with the help of FEOF. So FEOF will check the location of file pointer, and accordingly this loop will be repeated. After termination of this loop, I can close this file and then return 0. So this way I have implemented complete code in front of you. Now I am saving this file in C tc bin, and name of file is test.c, so it is already saved at this location. Now I am opening this location C tc bin, and here you can see contain.txt is already available. And you can see its contained, it is having the contained, my name is Sanjay Gupta. So contain.txt is containing this text. So now I am going to execute the code which will read this contain.txt. Now after execution, you can see the result. The content which were available in content.txt is showing on output screen. That is, my name is Sanjay Gupta. So this is done with the help of two functions. One is feof and another one is fgetc. Feof is checking whether file pointer is on end of file or not, and fgetc is reading a particular character available in a file. So this way you can control the loop with the help of feof so that you can check whether the file pointer is on end of file or not. So I hope you have understood the use of feof. In place of this loop, you can use another loop, that is while one, and here you can use fgetc fp. Now you have to check explicitly whether we are on end of file or not. So this way you can check it. If ch is containing end of file, then loop will be terminated. Otherwise you can print the character on output screen. So you can use this loop also in place of this while loop, but in this while loop you don't have to check whether file pointer is on eof or not explicitly, because it is done with the help of feof. So you have both the options. You can use any one, whichever is required. Now I am making this statement as comment, and I am again executing this code so that you can see whether it is working properly or not. You can see the output. My name is Sanjay Gupta is printed again on output screen with the help of this loop which I have implemented right now. So there are two ways to read content of file. You can use feof function to control the location of file pointer, or you can explicitly check the location of file pointer with the help of this if condition which is implemented in front of you. I hope you have understood whatever I have explained in this video. This is all about feof function used in file handling in C programming. If you want to watch more programming related videos, you can search my name Sanjay Gupta in YouTube. My channel will be available there. You can watch various programming related videos there. Thank you for watching this video.